Hello. So, today I was testing two manual lenses on my camera. One of them was 40 millimeters and the other one was 75. And as you can see in the metadata, if you go to camera, you can view that they're all set to 40 millimeters because I didn't change the slate on my Blackmagic camera. And I wanted to change this in post and found out that it's actually quite tedious and there was no good solution for this. But there was one person who suggested creating a sidecar file that has the start time code of the clip and the focal length in it. And this sidecar file is just a text file in the same folder as your clip, with the same name as your clip, except with an extension that says sidecar. But if you're going to do that for every clip, you would have to look for the clip details and start timecode. And I can't even copy this here, and then create a text file for each clip. And So what I did was I set up a little script that does this for us. And let me just show you my workflow on how to do this. I'm selecting all my clips that were shot with 75 millimeters. Then I'm going to File, Export Media from Selected Media Pool Clips. And I'm just going to call this 75 millimeters. I could just do another one, for example, if these were shot in another focal length, like 50 millimeters. Next, you will need the Python for your platform. If you haven't downloaded it already, you can just look for install Python on the internet and you can find it for free. And if you have done that, you can look for IDLE. I've saved it to the desktop already. And open my script, which I will link in the description. File. So this is the script that I came up with today, and there are just three parameters that you have to tweak in the beginning. So the first one is the location of your CSV file. Second one is the location of your clips, which is the same folder in this case, and the focal length that you wish to set these clips to. This is already set to 50, so let me run that code. As you can see, it created those sidecar files and they all have a start time code and a focal length in it. We can also just do the same thing for the 75 millimeter files. Save it and run it again. And then I usually have to restart Resolve so it reads those files in again. And looking at these files now, viewing the metadata, this is set correctly now. So we have those at 75, a few at 40 millimeters, and these, a few of those we changed to 50. I don't remember. Oh, the ones on top. Yeah, because they are all up to date here, but they are not up to date in your bin. So even if you already have something in your timeline imported, you can still just delete those and then import the clips again with the correct metadata. and everything will stay the same in your timeline. And now you have the proper metadata in your bin as well. So yeah, that's it. You can now go ahead and use gyro stabilization with the correct focal length in your clip. And this is what it looked like without stabilization. And this is now with the stabilization. Okay, so yeah, I hope that helps, and let me know if you've got any kind of issues, and I'm happy to help out with that. Bye.